the broad goal of my research group and our research here in the Earth and Environmental Sciences Department is to globally understand climate dynamics and to try to predict using these sophisticated models how climate change will affect ocean, atmosphere, and land over the next century and on longer timescales, a thousand years beyond that. Research in the past 10, 20 years has gradually focused on the Southern Ocean as being really important for driving global climate on long timescales. The Southern Ocean is the site where these deep waters form and also intermediate waters form that sink into the deep ocean and ventilate all the entire global ocean below 2,000 meters. As these waters sink, they take with them anthropogenic heat from the atmosphere. It also takes up of 40 to 60% of the anthropogenic carbon dioxide. These two processes are very good because they delay global warming, so to speak. The Southern Ocean has been freshening over the past few decades, and that is directly related to global warming. In a warmer world, high latitudes will get more precipitation. And as a result of that, we increase the surface freshening in the Southern Ocean, and this convective process and the process of deep water formation in the Southern Ocean slows down as a consequence. Eventually, we think that by the end of the 21st century, there's no more open sea convection in the Southern Ocean across all the current models. There are many interesting implications that we're just here in our group at Penn, we're just starting to touch on. We're looking at now at the implications of this process for heat storage in the ocean, or the stopping of this deep convection might temporarily result in additional storage of heat in the subsurface waters. If we are slowing down this convective processes, we're effectively slowing down the Antarctic bottom water, which feeds the rest of the ocean at depth below 2,000 meters. And this water takes a lot of anthropogenic carbon from the atmosphere. So if this water mass slows down, then we will be taking out less anthropogenic carbon from the atmosphere, which is effectively a positive feedback on atmospheric CO2 and global warming. We know the Southern Ocean is very, very important on these longer timescales. And the follow-up natural question that we are now pursuing is to understand whether the Southern Ocean is equally important on decadal and centennial timescales.